Hi all. Today I'm going to give some explanation about how to use token-based authentication in the BPM. So I think this is the some overall. I'm not giving step by step. I will just show the how I have implemented in one of my example. I wanted to share to you all. Please let me know if you need a source code. So I'm going to place in GitHub. So I will share that link to you. So at present, I already implemented and I verified. I will show you from the beginning. This is my computer little slow. Please bear with me sometime. So this is, I have created default MVC project with the web API from Visual Studio 2017. So I, as part of while creating, I have checked the option individual authentication. So it has added some ASP.NET membership authentication code by default. So I just updated token-based authentication on top of that. So if you create a new project in Visual Studio with the individual authentication, so it will add all OWN OIN authentication with the ASP.NET identity membership. You know, and these are the my solution explorer project view. So as I mentioned, I have created default project. So it has created a account controller, form controller, as well as manage controller by default. So I created a web API. This is the web API I have created, token-based controller. So this is the one you are seeing. So as we know that if you wanted to authenticate and authorize to my web APIs, we have to add authorize attribute on top of controller. So it can be controller or controller level or method level also. So you can ask, suppose if you wanted to add entire global level, we can register in global datasets files. So I have added this authorization, enabled this authorization on my web API controller level. So this is the one I have changed to enable authorization to my web API controller. I will come to this part last. So this is the first step I did. After that, I went to startup.authentication.cs file. This is my startup files. Let me increase the font. So every step it is taking too much time. So this is my auth file. So and this is the default code it has been added when I am creating this project. So let me go to that exact point where I have implemented auth token based authentication for my web API. So this is the where I have added. So this is the lines from, if you see, and I have added enable course to my website. Fourth means cross origin resource sharing. So it will suppose it domain change, normally JavaScript will not allow if you without enabling this. So I have enabled this one. This is the code I have added. So here if you see, here I am creating options for my authorization service. So this is the options I have created. So here the most important is this one, endpoint path, as well as when it is going to be expired. So I have by default it has created 24 hours, so we can adjust what we want for 30 minutes or 15 minutes other than 24 hours. So I'm providing the configuration to my auth providers. So I will go to this class. In this class I have configured my auth provider, which is going to give that token. So this is options. So once I created options, then I'm attaching this option to these two middlewares, I can say middlewares. So here I have added this option to the use auth broker tokens and use auth authorization service. So this is the steps I did. So indirectly it is going to, I have created the options and I'm giving this option to this service. So this is my auth service change. So after that, let me go to this class auth provider. I click F12, so it will directly go to that class. This is my class auth provider class. So here I have inherited from this class. So in this class, it has to implement these two. We have to override these two methods. So this code you will find if you browse, you will find this code. So basically what it is trying to do is, whenever try to call that service web API, so this code will execute. And here I am saying that whatever the user is passing the details, so it will come into the context. In this context, from this context I am trying to fetch those details. I am verifying with my database. So here I have used the SQL ASP.NET membership identity. So here I have already configured my membership. So from this manager class, I am trying to identify with the details, context, username and password, which I am passing. And if it is find the user, then if it don't, then I am returning the error saying that invalid. If it is find, I am attaching some claims. So here I am attaching name, emails, role, as well as lockdown, and this code is trying to validate with that identity. Once these are all success, then the request will be valid. Then I hope you understand this process. I will give again, so I will summarize that. Whenever wants to access this method, this action, this controller, this action, user first request the token user will need to request the token with like this in URL. So what is the request? Whenever user try to request the token, the server will return with valid token. The next request, user needs to attach the token and access this actual URL. If both are match, if server is valid with the token and with the role, if match, then user can able to access this. So this is how we can implement token-based authentication. Let me go and execute from the Postman. So this is my Postman get request. So this is the second time. So this is, so now if I try directly access, I think let me go on first. Let me go. Let's take that this user is valid at present. So let me go on and access with the invalid password. So I added the actual password is this one. So I added extra dollar. Let me go on. So right now a client should request for the token first. So let me go and request that token. So if these all values are success, then I will get the valid token from server. Let me see that. So this is how you need to pass. So you need to pass the header. You need to pass the body in your body. If username is called actual username, password is called this one. So this is important. Grant underscore type equal to password. So you should set this one, otherwise so you won't get. Yeah, if you see that I got that error from the server. If you see that HTML object reference not set instance object. So this is the error I am getting. So since I am passing invalid credentials, so I get this error. So here if you observe here, I am passing body in my request body, I am passing username, password, grant time. So grant what time? Because if you don't pass like this, then you will get error. So username, password, why I am passing? I am validating against my username, password in my heart service. That's why I'm passing. So I'm saying grant type is password. Since I passed wrong password, I didn't get that token, valid token. So let me go and remove that and send back again request for token again. You see here, now I got that my request got success. I got the new token. So let me. So I have the token. It is available. It is valid for until 24 hours. So to access my web API, so I need to go to my web API. So in my authorization, so in my authorization type authorization type, is bearer. So I selected bearer token. So I need to pass. So this is my valid token. Let me. And the header. So header is nothing. These are all normal. And this is the previous one. You just ignore this. But now let me go and try with the invalid one. I have added an extra access with the, let me go and send the request for the try to access my method. If you see that I have added invalid token. So if you observe is authorization has been denied for this request because my token is wrong. So let me go and remove that unwanted and let me try again. So if you observe here, I got the response back with valid data. So let me go now here, better understanding. So let's take, for my role is admin right now. So let me change here to state method. In your method, so it came here. Let me go on, try to access this my post method. User, let me go and so if you give another role and if you try to access here, we should get that to unauthorized access. So there is no role called user at present. So I just changed the post here and the token is same, but as per the for this token, the role is admin, but I am trying to access it to for user. So there is no role user here, so only admin. And let's build this one, build success, then I can, it is available for. Let me try, let's see that how it is, how it's behaving. So it's coming, no content found. I think code is not updated yet. Please remember these settings. So I selected X form this option and I am passing the my key and value pairs. I think it is taking time, so it's not somehow it's not coming here. Anyhow, I hope you understand what I am trying to explain. Please let me know if you need any more details. Thank you.